Good day and God bless you. Welcome to the Bible reading in chronological order. Just such a privilege to have you with us. I'm so grateful that you have joined and that we can share in the reading of the Word of the Lord together and the overview, just to delve into some of these scriptures and just to try and help us to understand the chapters that we're going through to some extent. Today we're busy in the book of Proverbs again, and we're going to be dealing with chapters 25 and 26. So we read that chapters 25 to 29 are actually the Proverbs of Solomon, which the men of King Hezekiah copied out. Now in verse 2 of chapter 25, it says, "It is the glory of God to conceal a thing, but the honor of kings is to search out a matter." Now this is a very important verse, because when we look at it in the light of how we study the Word of God, we become aware of how deep and inexhaustible the Scripture is. And it is so exciting to delve into the Scripture. Now, when we see that it says it is the honor of kings to search out a matter, we must remember that the Bible says that we are a royal priesthood. And so if we are royalty, that is putting us in that kingly line, which means that we need to search out the Scriptures in order to understand it. It is the honor of kings to search out the matter within the Scriptures, and that's so beautiful. And we see that it takes a lot of work, it takes a lot of study to get into Scripture. When we look at it in light of Isaiah chapter 28 verse 10, it says, "For precept must be upon precept, precept upon precept, line upon line, here a little, there a little." Not everything on one topic can be found in one chapter. No, you have to find it right throughout Scripture, and it has to line up from Scripture to Scripture to Scripture. And that's the beauty of the Word, because it gives us confidence in the Word of God that 66 books written over so many thousands of years can actually be so coherent and actually can be so perfect in the way that it's written. It's just mind-boggling, but it's also so beautiful. We see that the Scripture is like a jigsaw puzzle which fits together so tightly and reveals the most amazing picture. In John chapter 5 verse 39, it says, "Search the Scriptures, for in them you think you have eternal life, and they are they which testify of me," the Lord says. How beautiful is that? And then we see in verse 4 of chapter 25, it says, "Take away the dross from the silver, and there shall come forth a vessel for the finer." Now all of us can take a lesson from this and get rid of the baggages that weigh us down so heavily. Verse 11 says, "A word fitly spoken is like apples of gold in pictures of silver. An appropriate word spoken at the right time can be so precious. But we need to remember that the wrong word spoken cannot be retrieved. We cannot retrieve these words." We are reminded in verse 26 as well that a righteous man falling down before the wicked is as a troubled fountain and a corrupt spring. This is unethical. The righteous man needs to stand his ground. The righteous man needs to dig his heels in and serve the Lord and not be moved. And that is very important. Sorry, I got into a bit of a preaching mode there. But let's move to chapter 26. And we see that this chapter can be divided into three sections. The first section being verses 1 to 12. Now these verses focus on a fool and his foolishness. It tells us that as much as someone tries to help a fool, he will always return to his folly. Then we see the next section is verses 13 to 16. And these verses speak about a slothful and lazy person. The slothful are full of excuses and are even too lazy to feed themselves. It's so strange, but we see that this is the case. And this is not merely a parable, but this is a truth even for those that are so lazy in their way. Then we get to the third section, which is verses 20 to 28. Now we're going to go through some of these verses. I want to go through verse 20, which says, "Where no wood is, there the fire goeth out. So where there is no talebearer, the strife ceaseth." And this is so beautifully explained here, that if someone is not there to spread stories, that lie or that rumor will quickly die out. And that's important. We need to stop those rumors and those gossips. Verse 22 says, the words of a talebearer are as wounds, and they go down into the innermost parts of the belly. That is so true. The words of a talebearer can hurt. It can be so bitter in one's belly. It can actually cause people to even get sick through hearing of these rumors and these lies that were told about them. It's sickening to actually engage in gossip and talebearing. We are called to sow love, joy, peace, and the gospel of salvation. We are not called to carry tales and gossip. Then verse 27 says, whoso diggeth a pit shall fall therein, and he that rolleth a stone, it shall return upon him. And that's the same as the words of a talebearer. It will return to them, and they will lose all credibility. We're going to leave it there today. I pray that the Lord would bless you and keep you. May His face shine upon you. May He give you peace. God bless you as you enjoy the reading of the Word today.
Chapter 25. These are also Proverbs of Solomon, which the men of Hezekiah, king of Judah, copied out. It is the glory of God to conceal a thing, but the honor of kings is to search out a matter. The heaven for height, and the earth for depth, and the heart of kings is unsearchable. Take away the dross from the silver, and there shall come forth a vessel for the finer. Take away the wicked from before the king, and his throne shall be established in righteousness. Put not forth thyself in the presence of the king, and stand not in the place of great men. For better it is that it be said unto thee, come up hither, than that thou shouldest be put lower in the presence of the prince whom thine eyes have seen. Go not forth hastily to strive, lest thou know not what to do in the end thereof, when thy neighbor hath put thee to shame. Debate thy cause with thy neighbor himself, and discover not a secret to another, lest he that heareth it put thee to shame, and thine infamy turn not away. A word fitly spoken is like apples of gold in pictures of silver. As an earring of gold and an ornament of fine gold, so is a wise reprover upon an obedient ear. As the gold of snow in the time of harvest, so is a faithful messenger to them that send him, for he refresheth the soul of his masters. Whoso boasteth himself of a false gift is like clouds and wind without rain. By long forbearing is a prince persuaded, and a soft tongue breaketh the bone. Hast thou found honey? Eat so much as is sufficient for thee, lest thou be filled therewith and vomit it. Withdraw thy foot from thy neighbor's house, lest he be weary of thee and so hate thee. A man that beareth false witness against his neighbor is a maul and a sword and a sharp arrow. Confidence in an unfaithful man in time of trouble is like a broken tooth and a foot out of joint. As he that taketh away a garment in cold weather, and as vinegar upon nitre, so is he that singeth songs to an heavy heart. If thine enemy be hungry, give him bread to eat, and if he be thirsty, give him water to drink. For thou shalt heap coals of fire upon his head, and the Lord shall reward thee. The north wind driveth away rain, so doth an angry countenance a backbiting tongue. It is better to dwell in the corner of the housetop than with a brawling woman and in a wide house. As cold waters to a thirsty soul, so is good news from a far country. A righteous man falling down before the wicked is as a troubled fountain and a corrupt spring. It is not good to eat much honey. So for men to search their own glory is not glory. He that hath no rule over his own spirit is like a city that is broken down and without walls. Chapter 26. As snow in summer and as rain in harvest, so honor is not seemly for a fool. As the bird by wandering and the swallow by flying, so the curse causeless shall not come. A whip for the horse, a bridle for the ass, and a rod for the fool's back. Answer not a fool according to his folly, lest thou also be like unto him. Answer a fool according to his folly, lest he be wise in his own conceit. He that sendeth a message by the hand of a fool cutteth off the feet and drinketh damage. The legs of the lame are not equal. So is a parable in the mouth of fools. As he that bindeth a stone in a sling, so is he that giveth honor to a fool. As a thorn goeth up into the hand of a drunkard, so is a parable in the mouth of fools. The great God that formed all things both rewardeth the fool and rewardeth transgressors. As a dog returneth to his vomit, so a fool returneth to his folly. Seest thou a man wise in his own conceit? There is more hope of a fool than of him. The slothful man saith, there is a lion in the way, a lion is in the streets. As the door turneth upon his hinges, so doth the slothful upon his bed. The slothful hideth his hand in his bosom, it grieveth him to bring it again to his mouth. The sluggard is wiser in his own conceit than seven men that can render a reason. He that passeth by and meddleth with strife belonging not to him is like one that taketh a dog by the ears. As a madman who casteth firebrands, arrows, and death, so is the man that deceiveth his neighbor and saith, am not I in sport? Where no wood is, there the fire goeth out. So where there is no talebearer, the strife ceaseth. As coals are to burning coals and wood to fire, so is a contentious man to kindle strife. The words of a talebearer are as wounds, and they go down into the innermost parts of the belly. Burning lips and a wicked heart are like a potsherd covered with silver dross. He that hateth dissembleth with his lips and layeth up deceit within him. When he speaketh fair, believe him not, for there are seven abominations in his heart. Whose hatred is covered by deceit, his wickedness shall be showed before the whole congregation. Whoso diggeth a pit shall fall therein, and he that rolleth a stone, it will return upon him. A lying tongue hateth those that are afflicted by it, and a flattering mouth worketh ruin.